got Brian, four's got Nick. Are you ready to send him out? I'll count it into it, in 10.
All right, everyone, have a good show. Let's have some fun, okay? Here we go.
We're the Backstreet Boys, obviously. We're hanging in New York City, as you can see, and there's a lot of things to take in the city here in one day. That's all we've got. So we're gonna split up, we're gonna go our separate ways. Nick and I are gonna head to the basketball court. We're gonna catch up with these guys a little later. So take it easy. All right, man, take it easy. See ya. Be safe, right? Watch the fans.
Hello.
Then
we're just like brothers. We drive each other crazy, you know, but we love each other and we fight, but you know, it's just like family.
I think being a Backstreet Boy is a lot harder than people perceive it to be. Whether it's touring, recording, doing promotion, every day within itself is full of excitement.
I'm the happiest man alive when I'm on stage, but when we go on tour for like 2 months and we're off for a month, I'm miserable. I'm pulling my hair out, climbing the walls. I've got to be on stage. I have to.
I'm pretty hard on traveling just because, you know, I don't like to be away from home that much. But, I mean, it can be fun at certain times because, you know, you get to do things that are just, you know, not many people get to do.
What's up? It's Nick and Brian. We're down chilling on Houston Street. Is
Houston
that where we're at
Street,
right now?
Yes.
It was a long walk to here.
Famous court.
But we're getting ready to do one of our favorite sports. And as you can tell, it's basketball.
I played in high school. It's just something fun that I've always loved to do. I like to compete. I like all sports, but basketball is my favorite. Definitely.
Ready? Woo! That was switch two, man.
Me and Nick, I think, are going to challenge some of these fellas.
Hey, fellas, which one of y'all want to take a turn?
Now, you know, I like you and all, but y'all going to have to get out of the way.
Let's do it. Come on.
Go ahead.
One another? When we're on the road, we don't get to do as many things as we'd like to do.
Especially outside stuff.
Yeah. I mean, we try to bring everything that we possibly can with us.
Board.
Like, I bring my Nintendo. We bring, you know, mostly basketballs, footballs. And, you know, you try to find a gym or something like that to play in. I had nothing but D. You still burnt me.
It's just kind of hard for us to go out to a park anywhere and shoot due to the fact that there's a lot of people around or fans and stuff like that.
Oh, man.
It's all good now.
Let me tell you this something. This is where we kick in the fourth gear.
It's not like a 40-hour work week because our life is our job. It's pretty high in maintenance. Our job doesn't really allow us to come home and hang our hat, so to say, of what we do, because when you step out of your hotel room, that's life.
What'd I tell you? It's a Backstreet thing.
We have a schedule that's so demanding sometimes that, you know, we're on tour probably like 40 weeks out of the year, you know, and it's tough. It's nice to come home, sleep in your own bed, and do things like playing basketball or getting outside. 7-5? I look at basketball as being about as close to normal as we can get. Being at a park like this, being outside, enjoying the beautiful sunlight. A lot of times we're cooped up in venues and hotel rooms, and it's fun to get out.
Bread and butter, baby.
I'm tired.
You hear that? That's the ambulance coming to take these guys away after we beat them.
I think we appreciate a lot of things, the everyday life sort of thing.
You know, people take for granted, you know, what life's all about. You know, I think, you know, you just gotta enjoy every day, especially in our position. You know, we only get a certain amount of time to have time by ourselves. So it's like, you know, we try to use every day that we have.
That's game. Thanks for coming out and playing some hoops with us. We gotta go meet up with the other fellas, actually. Maybe do a little, I don't know what we're gonna be doing.
Tell
them. A little
talk to you later. Thanks a lot. We had a blast.
See ya.
See you later. I walk 1,000 miles, oh yeah.
My mom had always suggested to me, you know, a while back ago when I was in high school, you know, why don't you put like a group together, you know, maybe try to form your own band. And there was other groups that were out at the time, like New Kids and stuff like that. And I was just like, well, I wasn't really sure if a group was really like the right type of scene for me.
I've known Howie for about 10 years. Him and I met at a thing called the Latin Carnival back in Orlando, which is for all the Latino talent in all of Orlando. And both Howie and I are both Latin, so we entered the contest, and I did a 45-minute one-man show, and I beat Howie. And by beating him, we became friends. And we just hit it off really well, and we kept seeing each other at all kinds of auditions. It was like inevitable. You see the same faces wherever you go, especially if you're in the same city. And then we kept seeing Nick, and the three of us kind of vibed, you know, and we became really good friends. Started singing together off and on, you know, started a little trio, and got signed to, you know, small independent label back in Orlando. And our manager at the time wanted to add some more members to make the group whole. So we found Kevin, who was working at Disney at the time, apropos. And then Kevin brought us his cousin Brian.
So he called me, and the rest is history. That was April 20th of 93.
We've been through a lot together. 6 years. Nick was 13 when we first got started. He was this tall. Now he's as big, almost bigger than I am.
Being the fact that I grew up, you know, with them from the age 13 and up, you know, it's been just, you know, there's so many things that I guess, you know, a teenager can go through, you know, and they've been there for me. And, you know, we fight like brothers, you know, we're basically, that's what we are. And I think that's one of the reasons why we're so tight. And, you know, Kevin says it to this day, destiny brought us together.
That's not all. The 4th of July Zoom Concert Countdown will be right back.
Sydney inherited a piece of paradise.
The will is very clear. Sydney is the last remaining heir.
Now Sydney has to decide what to do with it. Thursday at 7, 6 Central.
You think we could find a buyer?
She came.
What happens to the beach?
She surfed.
Yeah!
She conquered. Don't miss Disney Channel's original movie, Rip Girls.
Do you think we could stay here?
Rip Girls. Thursday at 7, 6 Central, followed by Wish Upon a Star.
Stop!
Only on Disney.
Here's what's gonna happen. When 3 p.m. Friday hits, you'll have 3 days of freedom ahead.
Get your crew and take it for all it's worth.
And turn on Zoo Weekend's three things you gotta see. This week, don't miss 2-Hour Tour with Shadaisy. One, plus catch an episode of Z Games. Two, then don't miss an all-new episode of Even Stevens. That's three.
You've got 3 days, we've got three to see. On TV and online at ZooDisney.com.
Zoo Weekends.
Beginning Friday at 3, 2 Central, part of Zoo Weekends.
Day 29. Our hunt for wild bug juice campers has not gone well. Rations are low, as is morale.
This is lame-o!
And all we've captured so far is one annoyingly enthusiastic counselor.
Color bar!
Joe, there's an easier way to get info on bug juice. Check out ZooDisney.com. There's bios and clips on your favorite campers. Play online games against friends, sound app on the camp hall, and print out activities at home.
Friendship bracelets! All right!
Silence, prisoners!
See you there, Zookster.
Thursday on Disney, Disney pulls the old switcheroo.
It worked!
Meet Alexia and Haley Wheaton. Or is it Haley and Alexia Wheaton?
I haven't been myself lately.
Well, anyway, these sisters make a wish to trade lives.
I wish I were Alexia Wheaton.
See if you can figure out who's who in this Disney switcheroo.
And that rhymes.
It's Wish Upon a Star, Thursday at 8:40, 7:40 Central, right after Rip Girls, only on Disney.
How do you feel?
Tall.
We now return to Zoo Concert Countdown on Disney.
Well, the rest of the fellas are doing their thing, and I'm getting ready to do my thing. Are you
Hi.
Jenny?
Yeah.
I'm Kevin. Nice to meet
you.
This is the Claremont Riding Academy right here in Manhattan. You got a stable right in the middle of New York City.
Mm-hmm. The only one.
Yeah? The only one?
Yep.
My brother was actually the equestrian out of our family. He started in 4-H. And when I was younger, I used to be in 4-H and used to go on trail rides and stuff. But it's been a while since I've ridden it. Well, I borrowed some chaps. They're a little tight, aren't they?
That's good.
Yeah?
Tight. Yeah. Good. Then you won't get rubbed.
This tight?
Yeah.
We'll see if I can walk up these stairs. So what are we going to do now?
We're going to go pick out a horse he'd ride.
Okay.
And then bring him down and have a little ride around in here before we go out to the park.
Sounds great.
Great. Let's go.
When we do get a day off and when we're in a cool place that has a lot to offer like New York, I mean, there's tons of things to do. So, I mean, whenever we go overseas, I always go and check out the restaurants, and we'll all get together and maybe go play some basketball somewhere or stuff like that. You have a nice horse in here that I can ride?
Very nice.
Very gentle, nice, cool, mellow. Oh, that's what I need right there.
Here he is.
Ah, what's his name?
Trigger.
Trigger. The first big horse I remember having, his name was Amos. I was like 5 years old, and my little girlfriend lived next door. We used to play together all the time. I used to get some feed and stick it through the fence, and he'd come over and eat out of my hand. I'd climb up on the fence and just hop on his back, me and her, and we'd just sit on his back while he walked around and grazed all day. My mom said she used to look out the kitchen window and see us out there riding on him.
You want to just walk him around for a minute, just get used to him before we go out?
We used to ride bareback and play cowboys and Indians on our little ponies all the time. And if you're riding bareback and you get going real good, you're off. You just fall off. So we used to fall off our horses all the time. I think he's warmed up and loose. Park and Trigger. Yeah? All right.
He's ready.
Let's go to the park. Dodging traffic in Manhattan on horseback. I miss just sitting around thinking, wonder what I'm gonna do today. But with everything comes sacrifice, but we're having a great time. I'm having a great time. But I do miss the free time.
Hi.
Oh, I love the Lone Ranger. Yeah, Lone Ranger and Tonto. I used to watch that on TV, and I'd wear the mask around the house, and I used to pretend I was Zorro all the time when I was little. All right, check it out. We're going on the bridle path right now. It's 2.2 miles, and it's around the reservoir here in Central Park. So let's do it. But yeah, this is a lot different than riding out in the countryside in Kentucky. Got great scenery. I mean, riding in the country, you just, you know, got hills and grass and stuff to look at. Now you got, like, trees and grass and the reservoir and then the Manhattan skyline in the background. So that's pretty incredible. Riding in the park on a lovely day. I think we're ready to head back home now. Aren't we, Trigger? Yeah, he doesn't want to stop, see? So we're going. Bye-bye. Come on.
Show me the meaning of being lonely. I know.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Thank you. God bless.
Hey, everybody.
What's up?
Hey, Dave. And I'm Howie. We're here in New York City. We're off of Lafayette. We're going to do some shopping.
Shopping for us is difficult, but we try to do it as often as possible. I love to shop. We go to different countries, different states, and they have different things that Florida just doesn't have to offer. So, especially in like New York or in L.A., you can't go wrong.
Hey, dude, this looks like a place for you.
Center for the Doll.
It's definitely you. Come on, let's go. I hear AJ McLean is in this store. Is he? He is. AJ, that's not a Gomer Pyle hat for you, all right? I'd say probably of all the guys in the group, probably AJ and Kevin are like the most keen up on the latest trends and everything. I try to keep up with it, but I don't know. I mean, I don't know if I wear this stuff. I don't know. Oh, this is women's. No wonder. That's probably why I wouldn't wear this stuff.
I bring my brother along with me a lot on trips since we're constantly on the road all the time. We're not able to be with our family back home. It's cool for us to bring family out. AJ has...
This is my brother, John. Juan Carlos de Marcos. John Doris, my older brother. I definitely got the looks in the family, not him, right? Thank you. Thank you very much.
When I was growing up, my mom always gave me his hand-me-downs. I think I've worn just about everything he's had.
I had this one suit. She still got it to this day, and she still tries to make me wear it. It's this one, like, I don't know, it's got, like, plaid, and it's, like, gray and pink, and
I had to finally tell my mom. I kind of broke her heart and told her that, you know, some of the stuff just wasn't stylish anymore.
We wear the same size clothes. So in other words, he steals a lot of my stuff from me.
But now it's because we get so much clothes and stuff like that. Now my brother's constantly looking through my closet going, yeah, that's kind of cool. You still wear that?
Hold the press.
Uh-oh, AJ found hats.
Yes, he did.
We're in trouble now.
Yes, we are. Yo, this hat is sweet, man.
Sweet.
Like, when I go shopping, I try to find stuff that either nobody's got or that nobody would ever be caught dead wearing. You know, just something that's different.
Are you going to buy anything today? You know, dude, I have like a million pairs of shoes. I was looking at, actually, this is the one thing I like a lot.
How he doesn't buy shoes.
It's weird. When I go shopping, I'm very picky. Hey, they actually go with your outfit, bro.
Yeah, I might have to get these.
But I like watching AJ spend his money. He does a good job at that.
I'm an impulsive person. If I see something that I know I'm not going to see anywhere else, I have to have it right there and then.
You know, that's one thing I like about you, AJ. You're very spontaneous.
Hit me, help.
Don't ever do that again with me in public, all right?
Okay, shake your butt.
No, AJ?
In America.
All right, AJ, let's get out of here. You spent enough money already.
You don't just put the shoes on and expect to... Whoa. Got up a little too fast. Ooh.
Hey, that's like a big Statue of Liberty. This store, I guess, it's got a lot of antique furniture type stuff.
I'm assuming something blew up or fell down or they broke down a building or something and just took all the different... And they kept
all leftover pieces. Some pretty cool stuff in here. Lights and everything. Check out that sink. That's kind of different. We travel in so many different hotels, it's kind of weird. I mean, it's like some of them, the Art Deco-ish ones up in New York, I mean, they have to see stuff like this. And I have to end up, like, putting my shaving kit and everything on the floor. But some of the hotels, I like them with the big plush sinks and everything. It's really cool.
Brian, this is the perfect fan.
Kind of neat. In the very beginning, we used to, like, double up in rooms. We'd like take turns on who would be like, because there's odd guys, so somebody would get lucky and have like their own room for like a couple days, and then we had to like rotate. It was fun though. Like I said, that's when we really got to know each other back like 5 years ago, and like I said, we were roughing it.
B S B. 99. Let's get out of here before we get in trouble.
I'm a little picky, like I said, when it comes to stuff because I just have so much clothes already at home. I have like my parents, poor things. They've built like 3 closets in my house just to hold all my clothes.
Armani, I guarantee you'll find something at Armani.
Probably, like I said, we got Armani or whatever. Like AJ said, I'm a little bit more dressier kind of style person.
That's cool. I mean, that's you.
Exactly.
Last stop of the day, Armani Exchange. I'm going to hopefully buy something now.
Yeah, all right.
I'm destined to find something. Something.
This is bad.
I love that.
When I go shopping, I always look for stuff that, like, stands out because we're constantly... When we're doing photos and, you know, and being in the public eye, it's like, you really don't want to be caught wearing the same shirt in, like, 3 or 4 shots more, you know? It's like, so.
This is where it is, right? Can't follow me here, okay?
Woo! Cool.
Done.
Finally got something.
Finally done.
Did it.
We're out of here. You know, catch up with the rest of the guys. Go bowling. We're done.
No, we actually even got them a couple of things, too.
We missed them so much.
Bye.
See you guys.
Back straight, back, all right.
of July's Doom Concert Countdown. We'll be right back.
Lights. Camera. Jackson.
This summer, you can win the chance to jet out to Hollywood because Disney Channel wants to give you the star treatment in the Lights, Camera, Jackson sweepstakes.
You can win a three-night trip to L.A. where you and three guests will stay in a cool hotel suite, cruise around in a stretch limo to all the Hollywood hotspots,
and get a chance to join me for an appearance on Disney Channel.
Cool.
50 first prize winners will score a limited edition Silverstone cool jacket and an autographed picture from the cast.
Action. Sweet.
Go to any coin star machine in supermarkets throughout the country between June 18th and July 16th. Pour in $5 and change. Then take home your cash and a Lights, Camera, Jackson sweepstakes entry.
Ka-ching.
To enter, just send your name and address on a 3x5 piece of paper to Lights, Camera, Jackson sweepstakes. P.O. Box 4827, Chestertown, Maryland 21690.
Enter as often as you want. Winners will be announced on Zoo Weekends and at ZooDisney.com in August. And don't forget to watch the famous Jet Jackson, now on every day.
It's summer, and that means it's time to hit the beach, hit the trail, and hit the road. And your ultimate overnight destination is Walt Disney.
I love it!
Be there for classic movies, unforgettable series, and stars like you've never seen them.
Wow, that's a great idea.
So mark your calendar for a great summer getaway every night inside Walt Disney.
What's 2 hours tour?
2 hours tour.
Start with a bunch of unknown bands showing their taste to some of the biggest names in music.
Who?
Christina Aguilera, 98 Degrees, Shadazy, Savage Garden, Enrique Iglesias. Then it's narrowed down to three.
Three bands.
Then comes the audition, and the stars pick one band to open their show.
Make our minds up. We're so hard.
So who's it going to be?
Who?
Find out when you take the tour. 2 hour tour. Every month, and this month with Shadazy. Friday at 7:30, 6:30 Central, part of Zoo Weekends. We now return to Zoo Concert Countdown on Disney.
I want it that way, baby. I see the world so
Thank you. You guys have fun today?
Yeah, definitely.
Cool. Yes. Who's first?
A for AJ.
Oh, no, AJ! Wow!
Boo. I don't bowl, man. I sing.
Doggone it.
Mirage!
Yes! With these guys more than I am with my own family, so it's almost like we have become, you know, like five brothers. You know, we have our good times and our bad times, just like a regular family would probably have.
Looks like a field goal to me, Bob.
We're really proud of the work we've done on this album. We did a lot of the vocal arrangements, co-produced some things on it.
We don't really have even any kind of definition for what kind of sound it is. It's just the Backstreet Boys sound. It's just us, and it's real. I don't ever see an end to the Backstreet Boys. I think we all would like to grow with the times and make sure your audience grows with you.
You gotta get two strikes in a row in order to just tie me.
I think by sticking behind good quality music, and we've made a lot of important moves in order to get to where we're at now.
I'm 10 pins away from tying AJ, so I have to get a strike.
Still pick it up in time.
The last shot of the whole game.
Oh, I blew it.
Well, it was a great day. We were chilling in New York. We did all of our fun things. And we hope you enjoyed it too. There are some sacrifices that had to be made in order to be in this position, you know, which I thank God for everything that he's given me. But I think one of the things that I missed out on was of course just, you know, doing sports in high school or something like that, because I never got to go to high school. And I came right out of junior high and jumped into and doing tutoring because we were always traveling.
Being pulled out of high school was something that my parents were obviously worried about, because education is something that's very important, I think, to everybody. And it's something that kids should always keep in the back of their mind, because you can do anything you want, but if you don't really have an education, you know, I look at that as being a true success.
You want to graduate from high school. You want to have an education. It's a bare necessity. It's very important. And myself and Nick and Brian were getting tutored, you know, and I was in school up until my freshman year of high school, and then I got taken out of high school and put into my bedroom at my apartment doing school for 3 hours a day and then band rehearsal for 8 hours a day.
You know, stress with me in the very beginning. He's like, well, I want you to make sure you know, at least get your college education done. So I completed 2 years of college. I got my Associate of Arts degree. And like I say, and then at that time, we started really getting busy traveling around. And my family's just very excited every day, you know, to see the growth of it all, how, you know, where it started and where it is today.
My mom has been the greatest. She's been my mentor and my teacher since I can remember. My mother and father were separated when I was really young. So my mom and my grandparents were kind of the ones that raised me and drove me to all the auditions, and it was just nothing but supportive.
My mom sang at church every Sunday in the choir, and sometimes she would sing solos, and Brian's parents did the same thing. And then I started singing in the choir, and I started doing solos. I even did a duet with my mom one time for Christmas. And then I started singing in school, and so they just instilled a lot of love for music in me. My mom and dad were high school sweethearts, and they would win dance contests and stuff all the time in high school. And so they also instilled the love of getting down, getting funky in me too.
We have a brand new song, which is on the new album, a song that Brian wrote about a year and a half ago called The Perfect Fan, which is a song about our moms.
It's a song that kind of breaks generation. It breaks boundaries. It breaks age barriers, because of the fact that the Backstreet Boys aren't just for, you know, 9 and 10-year-old little girls running around. It's something that that everybody can listen to. You know, somebody can, we've got Mother's Day that just happened, you know, so it's something that I can give my mom and say, you know, Happy Mother's Day, Mom. It's something that I worked on that came straight from here.
I want to personally, I know the other guys, we want to dedicate this song to all the mothers in the audience, all the moms in the audience. This is called The Perfect Man. The big things, but the little things that can mean a lot. A lot of prayers to get me through. And there is never a day that passes by I don't think of you.
Thank you.